May I have your attention? Good morning, everybody. I'm very happy for being here, and actually I feel home, because as I said previously that my focus point, my point of view is PhD education or doctoral education. From this point of view, I would like to deliver for you today something might be interesting for you. It comes to my mind now, if you would like really to access the area of online or producing online research, how to start from this way, especially from data collection steps. Actually, we would like to shed a lot of lines under this kind of producing online survey. But before we are going to such kind of thought, we would like firstly to talk together about what's the meaning of online questionnaire actually. How online questionnaire or online survey looks like. What's the big deal behind online questionnaire? From that point of view, I called my lecture from bricks to clicks. You know such saying, from bricks to clicks? Actually, this comes from shopping, from marketing business field. A lot of companies shift their own services from bricks for being on the place itself to be, or for being online, to be online. That means eBay, for example, shift paradigm from shopping, from shopping all over the world. Now everybody can make shopping inside home, online. This kind of eBay, not only like Karstadt or like Media Market, I can go and buy stuff and deliver on the place, but as well I can do it online. This is what the meaning of from bricks to clicks, this kind of movement that we shift our paradigm to start to use online research, online data collection and so on. My lecture actually going in the direction of I'm doing here and sorry. Yeah. Okay. I would like to say firstly that you are very lucky because we have for you today fresh a piece of paper. We intend to provide it, to present it next week actually in Mannheim. And probably it's a nice opportunity to present for you as well this fresh result from our point of view. The point is, before this I would like to go from opposite side. That means we will not start from design online research, but we will start to think about what is the main aim of your online data collection. The main aim in your mind now to let people get access and let people filling out your questionnaire or drop out from your questionnaire. This is the main target of your online questionnaire. And we keep on this target in our mind right now to know exactly what kind of factor might be affected to such kind of filling in or drop out. This might be interesting to know from our experience. We analyzed three main surveys in frame of e-science project. Three main surveys in different time has been held on done, and as well we would like to know more about it, what kind of factor and so on. So our motto in this lecture, get data back on track. Get data back on track. That means if you would like to deal with online questionnaire, online data survey management, you find in such way some data is not used, it's not important. But we will try today together to reuse this data. This is the meaning of our motto today, get data back on track. As I said to you, we will describe this in the frame of our paper here. what factor affect this. I called it the fish model, and I will describe what the meaning of fish model, which has been proposed, and as well what factors affect participants while filling in an online questionnaire. Might be interesting to you to know exactly our experience, why people keep on to the end of questionnaire, and otherwise some people drop out from the middle or drop out from the beginning. This is, might be interesting to know what kind of reason behind it. This, as I said, it will be presented next week in Mannheim, but I would like as well to share you today this kind of thought. Theory behind this kind of view is fish model. What's the big deal of fish model, and why I called it fish model? And what's theory behind it? The point is, our point of view, how to understand online behaving. That's very, very important for marketing and for business, to know exactly how people behave online. How people behave during filling in your online questionnaire. This is very important to know as well. So that means this is the result of more than 200 pieces of paper already analyzed. 200 pieces of paper already analyzed to reach or to provide some kind of proposed model. We will go exactly so, that we will describe online filling in or drop out online questionnaire in terms of many aspects here. The first aspect is task with time, activities versus belief, support versus context, incentives versus ethic, and at the end, collaboration. The matter here is to understand if people would like or intend to collaborate with you or not. What factor behind it you should consider it, should put into account before you design your online questionnaire. Let us start from briefly, because we have a lot of data, and we would like to share you actually this really, really a big amount of statistics and data. What's the meaning of task and time? Task should be done by you as author. What should task you have to do to deliver your questionnaire in terms of design, in terms of graphical user interface should be considered, in terms of deliver fast and easy message to participant, and in terms of as well marketing. In which way you deliver, you announce for your survey. Some people use email. Okay, I have now online survey and I use email to just we call it here round email or round email at university. I send and I wait for 2-3 weeks until I receive some kind of allowance, and then for everybody already delivered. This one kind. Second, might be interesting to do it by yourself. You have some contacts, you have some friends, you know professors, but you should recognize exactly the law of data privacy here, because as you know, data privacy is a big issue, and it should be considered actually when you deliver, when you send the email, under any cover you send it, which umbrella you send under it. This is very important to know. This is the task. Time. An online survey, let us say culture, what should be accounted, how many times or how much time should be provided for users to fill online questionnaire? And as well, when exactly might be interesting to know when exactly people fill in online questionnaire. We have experience here that people, there are various kind of certain people. Some people would like to participate in the morning at 9 o'clock, take a cup of coffee, I'm still fresh, let us help people a little bit and then follow it. Some people, in German culture here, I observe that after lunch, they call it in German, Koma, Schnitzelkoma, exactly. That means people are a little bit lazy and would like to, okay, I'm not focused now to do such critical work, so maybe I would help people better to do nothing. This kind of activities, kind of culture of filling in online questionnaire should be considered as well. When exactly you should send email, and when you expect filling in or drop out from people. Activities, beliefs. Activities. When you already deliver your email, you expect two kind of action or reaction from people. The first is people would like to know more about your research. So some people send email in terms of, okay, I'm really interested with your research. What's the next? Huh? Could be please, would you like please to inform me immediately about your next step of research or not? This kind of communication as well. How to attract people and to keep on with people after filling in online questionnaire for next online questionnaire, for next data collection. It's very important to keep customer with you, open it. In marketing point of view. Not only, okay, please fill in and just finish it. No, try to make connection. Try to keep people on with you. Huh? Try to make your community. Huh? When you need in the future some kind of customer, you will find people around you. You will find your already your own community behind your back. This is some kind of activities. Belief, it's not kind of belief from God or belief from... It's kind of work beliefs. Work beliefs, that means, you know, there are kind of way of scientists called disciplines territories. Have you ever heard about disciplines territories? That means each discipline has his own circle. If any other disciplines come to access this, stop, this is my point of view, this is my area, this is my... Huh? We observe this all the time when you discuss with colleagues and he try to access your area and you are expert in this area. And you consider him, he is not expert like you. So you stop him, please. This is my field. This is my point of view. Stop here. That means some kind of, you know, we call it disciplines territories. Each discipline has such own culture to respond about your or to understand your questionnaire. That means you have a big task to deliver your own message easier and faster. That means you should care about different kind of ages, different kind of disciplines which you deliver it. For example, we have experience to deliver some kind of questionnaire about using Web 2.0 for doing research. And we had to make some kind of explanation, description. For what is the meaning of Web 2.0 for everybody? We understand Web 2.0 totally different than mathematics, than chemics, than medicine, than even in informatics. When I ask my colleagues work with me with e-science, okay, how do you perceive Wiki as a tool? And what kind of tasks you can handle by Wiki or you can do or achieve by Wiki. He has totally different kind of understanding what's the meaning of Wiki than me, what's the meaning of blog than me. I can use blog for, you know, document my daily task, document my daily activities, but he used blog for announcing, for some kind of marketing, some kind of, it depends in which context. We always say that it's a tool like water. If you bring water and make a tea becomes tea. If you put a water and make juice become juice, that means tools, it's neutral. And you have to deploy it in your context. If you understand the tool from your context, doesn't mean that others understand similarly with you. This is should be considered very, very important because I will show you feedback from people. One colleague said, what the hell is this? You send me what? I don't understand what you send to me. What the Web 2.0 means? Huh? I don't understand. What the, and you didn't even give description for what the meaning of Web 2.0. Huh? It make big mess. Huh? And nobody really feel warm to fill in your online questionnaire from this kind. So you break heart, colleagues, from first page. You have to be considered and you have to be careful, very careful when you are running with this aspect. Second is support and contexts. Support issue is kind of technology. What kind of technology are used? And as well, if you use some kind of, you know, we have some kind of, I would say it's kind of developing of tools. People start paper from paper based questionnaire, and then they make shift paradigm to use email. And then when I would like to say, starting from 2005 comes to us Web 2.0. Web 2.0. And people becomes crazy about this tools. It's completely free. You can use it. You can deliver all of your message nicely way, socially way. Huh? You feel home with people, close, social action, not a social email. And please fill in and push people. No, just let communication be connected. Huh? So this is kind of some kind of consequences. And this is what I mean with support of technology. Huh? What kind of technology do you use? And which criteria should be accounted? Should be accounted to deal with this. Email, just I write email and send, or some kind of criteria should be considered in terms of low, in terms of message, easier to be delivered, in terms of, in which direction should be delivered, what kind of message should be delivered, and so on. Web 2, what kind of Web 2? Web 2 as well, it's some kind of ironically issue. That means, okay, it's for all, free, open access, but as well, data privacy a little bit. So how to make balance to use Web 2 as helpful way for deliver your message, and as well to keep issue of data privacy as well in the front of your eyes. This is as well what I mean with technology. Context. Context, as I said to you, it means with many, many stuff. Like we have international students. We are here international students. It's very, very, very nice atmosphere because I can just raise one concept and receive from you different kind of perspectives. Everybody would raise it, would answer it from his own culture, from his own background, from his own point of view. This is very interesting to be considered. If I deliver my message for local or for international, this is from first line. Or I will deliver as well, can take part here as well some kind of age or culture aspects of disciplines as well. For example, right now, our colleagues in mathematics prefer Blackboard and to write directly. They don't like to use online tools. They said, no, it's not because I'm scared from new technology, but because to protect my work. Huh? Look how the thought coming. Huh? They shift it from being scared from new tools to protect my work. This aspect of protection now, he was talking to us. No, I prefer this because students have pen and papers and write after me, and everything's saved. Everything's directly. Nobody from outside can access and so on. Data privacy, protection of work, protection of lecture. This issue as well should be considered. If you would like to access such kind of mentality, you have to find a way. It's not easy. Incentives and ethics might be interesting for you to hear. If I will deliver my questionnaire, okay? Some people make like this, okay? I will give Gutschein in German, like gift. I will give 20 euro Gutschein to fill in my online questionnaire. If you would like to have, for example, 1,000 students or 1,000 participants, so with 20 would be 20,000, huh? You need a lot of financing from your project to fulfill this requirement. Some other people say, okay, no. The motivation should be internal. That means I will deliver my message inside my interested community. That means people around me, colleagues, and so on, they already have some kind of interest. That means they will take part from my questionnaire, not because they want to help, but as well, they want to be satisfied. Huh? Satisfaction, self-satisfaction. Okay, what you are doing, actually, I don't know. And here you know, when I go to you and ask directly what you are doing, might be it's, you know, it's a tough question to be answered. Huh? What is you? Just I know you right now and you're asking me about your work. But if you participate in your online questionnaire, everything will be open to you. You know exactly in which point you are working, huh? Indirectly. You make two in one. I helped you or you helped me, and as well, I feel satisfied, full satisfied to your data. Which kind of buoyant project are you working now, and so on. This kind of context, incentives. Ethics as well should be covered from data privacy issue, from law of data privacy in your university. Like here, I cannot take advanced step without asking university. And from data privacy unit, they have to come and have a look what I have wrote. If you have contact in Brisium or something under your questionnaire, huh, or not. If you ask people to give you your, to give you their emails, this is forbidden in terms of data privacy. Huh? Don't ask people to give you, because you can connect emails with all filling in data, and this is not allowed. So it should be considered. I will not take a long time in this issue, but I would like to just raise for you what kind of model we have raised, we have developed, in order to develop online behaving from people taking part in online questionnaire. Let us see our research questions. What factor affect participant 12 filling in an online questionnaire? As I said to you, it's some kind of connection between timing task, gender activity, discipline activity, and as well motivation and some kind of ethics issue in terms of trust. This is the main question, and we would like to present our data in terms of this kind of information. Okay, what we have now? The method. Method for our research, data has been collected from three, as I said to you, from three main surveys. Has been taken part in e-science project. This is here. I take part from this project as well, and this three kind of survey has been done in context of this project here. And we would like to have a look what happened during in filling in or drop out from online questionnaire. The main focus of my presentation today, completed versus dropped out attempts. That means we will make some kind of comparing always between people who filled out to the end, completed, and people who dropped out in the middle or in the beginning, at the end, doesn't matter. Huh? But we will take into account some kind of combining situation between completion and dropout. And as I showed you before, our model to describe some kind of activities. What's the main issue behind it? Have you ever heard about Barra data? Barra data is a main issue when you are going to observe how people filling in or drop out from your online questionnaire. It's called Barra data, administrative data about your survey. We were using for all three surveys Unibark. That means data has been collected by our tools, official tools at Dresden University of Technology, Unibark. And the Barra data in the meaning of we collect all data. Normally, when you collect the data, if you have, I heard that two of you designed the past certain kind of questionnaire. The point is, when you collect the data at the end, you make some kind of sorting. Okay, when you have, for example, your sample was 10 people, and the 5 already completed at the end, but still other 5 drop out. So what you should do actually, you take off this data. You don't need this data at all because it doesn't matter for you. It doesn't make any sense for you anymore. Huh? They didn't complete online questionnaire. That means I don't need them in terms of statistical analysis. I focus only about people who complete online survey. I don't care about those. But in our research, we need both. We need to see exactly why those people, doesn't matter for us completed cases, but the matter is dropped out cases. Why people actually dropped out? What's the big reason behind it? Huh? And how we control this in the future? This is actually interesting questions to raise. Huh? In order to say in the future, please, if you would like to make online questionnaire, be careful. If you face dropped out cases, you should care about 1, 2, 3, 4. And this is our distribution of this paper. Let us see what's happening. As I said to you, this is the main tool to collect BARA data. Okay, let us have a look about the first survey. First survey was mine survey. This is the title of my research. Above here, modeling research in academia. Target group was doctoral students at University, Dresden University of Technology. All doctoral students at University of Technology. Structure of survey should be considered for you. If you would like to make online questionnaire as well, which structure you should follow, and as well, if this is really good choice or there are other recommendations should be taken in account. As you know, starting from demographic data, some kind of gender information, age information, and so on, and status, academic status, and so on. And then concerning to my online survey, I asked about kind of support needed by PhD students. I asked about tools already used for doing research during your dissertation time. I asked for to whom you contact, and this is, might be interesting. Are you intend to contact with colleagues only, or with international colleagues, or with, let us say, industrial field or contacts, and so on? What kind of contacts and in which direction you go? And academic task might be interesting for you as well as PhD students to know exactly what kind of certain task you are going to do every day, frequently, and one per day, per week, one per day, one per month. We need to know this, huh? In order to decide exactly to what extent might be interesting to offer for you some kind of help in terms of technological aspect or technological technical tools. And comes at the end some kind of attitude scale. Attitude scales, you ask people about their emotion, about their feeling for using such media, and you can select, you can use some kind of 3 option or 4 option or even 5 option or even 7 option. That means you can say, okay, I use frequently every day Facebook, for example. So I accept, strongly accept, or I accept, neutral, I don't accept, for example. Or you can use 4 option or 5 option. 5 option, this is much common in research, in social science. You can say, for example, I strongly agree, I agree, neutral, I disagree, I strongly disagree, for example. So this kind of options. And as well, might be interesting for you to know exactly, as well, might be culture here affect the situation. For example, I came from Egypt, for example. When I ask Egyptian For three only, it's not enough to say, okay, say me your opinion, but I just keep him only here, between three options. Might be he lost somehow. It's not here. I feel here. I feel some here, maybe. So you have to make more options to let people have a little bit wide range of options to select. This as well should be considered. This is what I mean with attitude scale. This survey has been run in July till October, 3 months. Might be you hear that online questionnaire should take only 10 days or 1 week or 2 weeks maximum, because people, you inform people and the people are very, very high motivated, and then people come low again or comes, so it doesn't matter if you keep it for a long time. But I will describe why I kept it for a long time like this later. Important data, the total sample was 938 and completed only 140. This is amazing. This is amazing. Why this amount of people dropped out during filling in? What was the reason actually? Because this is really waste a lot of energy. When you have only almost 1,000 people filled in your online questionnaire and at the end you find only 140 only completed your questionnaire, this is, I would be crazy. Why? Why I have done some kind of activities? Why people already run away from my online questionnaire? What I have done wrong? Why I didn't keep people keep on with me during filling in? This I will describe later. What I mean with lurkers. Do you know what the meaning of lurker? Probably you know. Lurker, it's a concept, is very famous in terms of using online social media. If you are a teacher at university, for example, if you use with your students some kind of forum, online forum or social network, you can find people participate and very active. And the other doesn't even bought one letter, but doesn't mean that they are run away, but they are access and read only. But they don't participate. They don't share your information. Those people known as lurker. Known as lurker. That means they access your survey, but they didn't fill anything. And they make for me as author big problem. Because they are not motivated to fill in, as well they destroy something. They make some kind of confliction here. And how I know that they are lurkers? And they are not dropped out people or dropped out symbol. When they are run away from first page, that means they are just click and they read, blah, 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 blah. Nah, I don't have time. Nah, I am not interested. Nah, and so on. This kind of lurkers. Okay, I access by the way to see what's happening, who is this person who is doing, what's his background, and always observe that when you deliver your online survey, if you have account in academia.edu. Academia.edu is an online portal for researcher. And very interesting that when anybody search about you in Google, for example, Academia sent to you an email. Hey, somebody was searching about your data. This is very interesting to know. And this is a big issue from online research methodology, to access this door now, because a lot of profit you will get, you will receive from such kind of portal. And I know, it sent me an email, hey, one guy, or I don't know, I have searched about your profile in Google 5 minutes ago. So I know that some people search around me. Why? Because I deliver some kind of questionnaire. People want to know who I am. If I have really interesting background to collaborate in the future for me or not. This is very interesting for you as a researcher in the future, as a teacher as well, to market yourself, to show yourself, to show your background. Completion rate is very low, actually. And daytime of most axis count as 9 for 143. And the average number of participations per day, it's 11 almost, or 12. Average number by participant by week, 55. Page with most dropout introduction, be careful. And tools and tasks for my questionnaire was the third page. The third page. And people were very, very confused, actually strongly confused, because I was repeating some issue, but it was actually not repeated. It was with different kind of understanding. But people doesn't get it or don't get it. Why? Because as I said in the beginning, you have to describe your concept firstly to let people understand it very good and let them to be more open for your questionnaire. This is the first view, the first survey. Second survey was for my colleague Anya Lawrence from Chemnitz University of Technology, and she was interested to deliver her message for teacher community, teacher at Saxony State Universities, only for teacher. And structure of her survey was demographic data, as I said to you, research and project, use of Web 2.0 tools, frequencies of publications, attitude scale as well. As well, the same, about 3 months. And we will describe why she let it as 3 months. Here, the main point is complete or total sample, almost 800. Completed 253. Look how it's a really big drop. And this is, we need to ask ourselves, we need to raise this question, why a big amount of people dropped out? And response rate might be it's higher than my questionnaire. Takes time, 14 minutes to fill in. The first was almost 20 minutes. And as well, here, higher number of participants per week. Page with most dropouts is introduction. As well, introduction. That means lurkers more than others. Third survey with the same context was survey comes from coordinator of our project, eScience. This is coordinator survey. Was the most simple one. I mean, it includes not so many information, simple design, simple kind of message should be delivered, and so on. And this is the content as well. All about the target group was actually scientists, supposed to be, and as well, here's the most interesting, 27 days has been held it. Look, here's a number, 1,000, almost 1,200 people already participate, almost, huh? Why? Because the target group was not only in TU Dresden, but as well in all Sachsen universities and college has been delivered. Daytime of access here, it was 7 a.m., but in our tools was Greenwich time, that means plus two, that means the most access time for this questionnaire was 9 a.m. As well, it can be a reason that people feel fresh, people have a cup of coffee and start to help others or start to be curious about maybe this is coordinator project, that's something, it's expected to be something high, eh? Something very interesting. Eh? So why not to participate? So the most people access in 9 a.m. in the beginning of the day. And the most drop page as well is the first page introduction. As conclusion from those kind of three surveys, you see here what has been done. Be noticed, please, that the first survey has been conducted in English language as well. Might be an issue as well, because not everybody is familiar with changing language or with foreign language as well. Might be a reason, huh? Not all, but might be. As well, it was because this is my questionnaire was too long somehow. Was people feel some kind frustrated to complete it because it includes a lot of information. I will show you a screenshot from it and so on. For my colleagues here, as well, this is similar to my case, but here as well, it's top, on top. This is a survey of, in my opinion, survey of our coordinator was on top in terms of collecting a lot of people. Dropout not was really long, big amount. Comparing dropout here, almost 300 from 1,000. It's okay. It's not like me, for example, 1,000 and dropout of 400 or 450. This is almost half, you know. This is as well should be considered. Some kind of information as well. You should as well, you know, a little bit stop here and think a little bit. Why does happen? And what should I take in into account in the future? Okay, let us go a little bit in details. Might be something will be interesting. Here we will start with task and time. Firstly, task. Task, as I said to you in the beginning, done mostly by authors. What which step you should follow in order to deliver at the end your questionnaire? Look, we have two main steps, really interesting. The first is design matter, and the second is marketing, the way of deliver your message. Here you will see enhancing online forms. This is a big issue for your task to develop online questionnaire. Be careful, you should enhance online form. Let us see how it looks like in our questionnaire. This is three questionnaire. Let us see, for example, this kind of. The number of main question was 23. 170 items has been asked, and it includes 13 page in computer screen. And here, you can see somehow, you can. I don't know, do you have mouse outside? This is external mouse. Could you please give me? Look here how many in one page. This is one screenshot. This is one only screenshot. How many screen has been designed? This is too much for reader. It's too much, definitely too much. Huh? But the point is, you reach to such thought that you have to decide one from two. If you have a lot of questions and you have completely up some kind of, you know, tab for completion. This is. When you access one page, it's here. When you access second page, it's here. So it gives relief to participant. Okay, I have done. I almost finished.
But this can be also be very demotivating. So if you finish one page, another page, then this bar doesn't go on. So I'm very demotivated and I quit the question.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly.
I think you have to be very careful with that.
This is. But you have to decide as well. If you have a lot of questions, you have to deal with it somehow. Huh? You can take one against one or one with one. Select your tactic or strategy. Huh? You can just put, if all of this question related to each other is one point, one aspect, you don't have choice, actually. You have to put it one time because it's everything's connected to each other. If you make it separated for three screens, for example, it will, for example, reach at the end to 18 screen. And here, this is progress tab will be very, very slowly. And yeah. And you feel really frustrated. No, it's till now, I have to acquit.
From my point of view, it's actually not a matter of the number of questions or items. It's a matter of expectation. So when I expect, or when somebody told me that the questionnaire will take about approximately 30 minutes or something, and it takes me 2 hours to complete, and I'm completely Mm. But if I know that it would take 30 minutes and it just takes exactly 30 minutes as it says here, then I'm probably
satisfied. Yeah.
Mm. So I go through all these questions and say, okay, moving along.
This,
So it was just a comparison of these two opinions I just gave. It's not simply a matter of the number, but it's a matter of, for me, it's a matter of expectation in the beginning.
This is, I could say, this is one opinion. And second is really matter progress step. And for people, they are very interested to know and to deal with it really. But actually, they chase the time, chasing the time all the time, chasing the train. I have to run because I have many, many tasks behind me and so on. So I need to take this advantage and as well to save my time. And for you as author, this is some kind of tricky. You have to find a way to not lose the participant, and as well as to meet or to meet his expectation from your online questionnaire.
And it takes me 2 hours, then I'm really fair and just leave it like that. But if I already know from the beginning that it will take me 2 hours, then I just reserve the time to do it in a special moment of the day, do nothing else, and then it's okay that it takes 2 hours, but because I knew from the beginning. And so it doesn't make a difference for me if the questionnaire is small or big or huge or whatever. It is a question for me to just to find time on the day to place it and to just get the job done.
But the motivation for you in this moment is self-satisfaction or just to try to help people? What kind of motivation you have when you decide to fill in this moment?
I think it's two aspects. To do it at all, there's a kind of motivation. So I can decide very beginning, if I do it at all, or if I just leave it. But when I decide to do it, then it's kind of, for me personally, it's a kind of management. I need to decide at what time of day I fulfill or I answer the question in the questionnaire. So if somebody tells me in an email, for example, please take part in this questionnaire, it will only take you 5 minutes, blah, 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 and I take this for proof, and I just place the questionnaire in a short break to do it in these 5 minutes, and then I realize it takes me 2 hours, actually. And it's a big disappointment breakdown. But if I really know from the beginning it will take me 2 hours, then I place it to a completely different time of the day, okay? And then it will be okay that it takes 2 hours, because I know.
The point is, nobody knows that it takes 2 hours. Why? Because as I said to you, it's a matter of understanding. It's a matter of discipline and the culture. You know, if I deliver for you from my point of view, what's the meaning of Web 2.0? From my opinion, from my background, from my research theoretical background, and I give you one time, expectation from you to understand similar than me is an issue. Exactly. I decide for myself concerning my understanding that it takes 15 minutes. But when you receive it, what is this? What the hell is this? You know, it's very big. What do you mean with this aspect? What do you mean with that aspect? And this is a matter of understanding as well. So it's pretty hard to decide. 100%, it's okay, take 15 minutes. And this is a tricky way. This is a tricky issue. And you should be careful. And what we are going to do to reduce this kind of level, to reduce it, to make it a little bit low, in terms of providing more explanation, in terms as well with design online questionnaire to make some kind of feedback button, faster feedback button in screen. For example, if you're stuck in one page, and you don't know exactly what that means, you can stop here right now and you can send the feedback to the author himself to describe it back and then pew, give you feedback directly. And this is our recommendation from this paper to redesign, to think about redesigning of online questionnaire. Exactly. But this is the point as well. If you, as well, it depends. If you feel really high motivated in this moment, to fill it, and then 2 days later it becomes a very cold issue. That's okay. It doesn't matter anymore. So this is issue as well. So we are really dealing with some kind of tricky kind of tools of design. You have to as well to consider everything around you. Yes, I can make feedback as well. I can make it a very, very communicative form, very, very helpful enhancing the design of online questionnaire. But on the other hand, I don't have any guarantees that the user will come later to complete it. This is one issue as well. Maybe he will stuck and forget here. And you should send him again to do something here to know exactly who dropped out here and to resend an email. Please come back to finish it. I answer your point or I answer your question, for example. So this kind of as well, it's like coins. It has two faces always.
On that service without the possibility to save the enter data.
This is a matter of design and a matter of developing it, and we need to raise this up. We need to say for development, for this Unibark, for example, CEO, please take it into account, some kind of function, features for your system to be really much more easier with delivering message or message, and as well to reduce dropout numbers. This is the point.
One way could be, you said it before, you said that the participants, they have a motivation to take part. So one big point in this motivation is to satisfy this interest of the participant in a way that he gets a result at the end of the questionnaire, for example, intermediate results. So in case you just save the questionnaire, you won't get intermediate results because you haven't finished it yet. So for to get a motivation for the participant to complete the questionnaire, you say to just get the intermediate results when you complete and fill out the questionnaire. So you
Yeah, and it could be as well as extension of your idea, as well to make some kind of storytelling, or telling a story. When you just deliver your message, you make it as a story. For example, if it takes a really, really long time, you need to communicate somehow with participant. You have done already, for example. One between slide or one between page here, you are great. You are done. For example, if you deal with kids, if you deal with adult or something, great. It has soon will be done. So, something like this, or some kind of There are a lot of tricks you can make. You can make just some kind of quote. A lot of this is idea. A lot of research quotes online. You can say, for example, okay, this is to help us to not, for example, steal from one research is plagiarism, but steal from three research is a research. For example, this one quote called like this. If you steal from one paper, that means a plagiarism. If you steal from three paper, that means a research. for example, to make some kind of funny atmosphere with the participant. Okay, you will help us here to not, for example, blah, blah, blah. This kind of really, it's a message, it's a communication, it's a matter of communication. Your questionnaire, it's a matter of communication. You develop not only questionnaire, but you develop some kind of communication tool. But in terms of scientific communication tool, this in my understanding like this. It's not matter really that you need only to fill in. It's a matter to be known in your point of view, to let other know your work, to involve your community, to collect your peer around you. It's a lot of matters for you as a researcher, as a scientist. It's not matter only for online questionnaire. If you look to the online questionnaire as online data collection, actually this is a narrow point of view. If you look at it as communication to show off your background, to show off how you are interested in this point, you are here, you are visible, I'm visible here in TU Dresden, for example, in my point of view, this is very important. This actually, this is.
For example,
Why not actually? Why not? It comes to my mind now. Why not to make as online questionnaire as a game, for example, as a game? Why not? It's really interesting to me to hear this. it's really interesting, and it's a field of really. Creativity. You can just put your own way, your own method. I cannot really deliver for you all idea. You might be you are more creative than me. You can just see the point and you know your own culture, you know your own community, what it makes really them feel nice to get it. For example, in Christmas time, people are very nice and they intend to give money without any sense, for example. Really, if you stand in Bragarstrasse and they make, yes, I'm singing Egyptian song and I'm a very funny person, and you both just plate, you will collect a lot of money, actually. I will try it. You know, but the point is, it's smart to know exactly when time you get the data from person. This is very interesting to know. As I said to you, if you deliver the message in the middle of the day, people have coma of lunch. I need any things to do than doing my work. Maybe I will help people. This is very interesting to use this chance. For example, so you know, and you have to find all the time tricks and ideas to push people to get your data easier, interestingly, and faster. It's not measured by us, actually. This might be an interesting question. I have read one paper called like this. If there is a difference from response, depends on time of the day. Exactly, the same what you ask it. But the point is, they make online, they make experiment for two or three groups together to collect such data. But which way I already followed, this is Barra data. I didn't make any experiment. I took only three survey has been done and collect data which already available with Unibark. I didn't make any experiment and I cannot reach to answer your question with my data. But it's really interesting and you should develop some kind of experiment to measure some kind of question. And this is our recommendation as well. That is my recommendation for all of you as well. If you are willing to design online questionnaire in the future, please take into account Barra data as well. It's very, very, very interesting to know exactly when people, if people interesting with your questionnaire or not, when time they like to fill in. For example, ask them directly. Not receive, but ask them exactly. This is my recommendation for you to include such questions, two or three questions in your questionnaire, but you will get really, really interesting result. Yeah. This is first. This is second from my colleagues. This is as well some kind of introduction. For example, this is my colleague Anya Lawrence from Chemnitz University. It's allowed me to publish her own data. It's allowed, so it's not matter now. But just look to as well some kind of design issue. Huh? Design issue and data should be included in first. In first page as well. Contact the person is very important in terms of trust, in terms of ethic, huh? That there are reference for this research, as well as the logo of e-science project, it's known in Saxony. Huh? It should be as well included somehow. And in our Unibark, there are some kind of comment. That means if you already would like to design online questionnaire, and before to distribute it, you should give for pretest for colleagues. And you can make some kind of comment that everybody can write to you comments about this. It's not clear. It's you give you somehow feedback, and you take into account in the future. This is as well how to design the first page. This is the screen from coordinator project. It was as well simple one. Comprehensive data here and website always should be included to let user as well know more about your research, about your background, about your colleagues, about your community. And yes, to make it simple as possible, huh? Because people not are going to waste a lot of time to reading your story. You are not going to tell your story long way in first page. Just make it very simple. And here, as should be 10 minutes. But as I said to you, it's tricky. 10 minutes for me, it's not 10 minutes for you. Understanding for questionnaire for me, not like you. Not like others, huh? Different. But we say, okay, might be it's 10 minutes. But please do not take in your account that when it will take 15 minutes that I am liar or I lied on you. No, but you have to consider it that I make it, okay, from my perspective of, and from pretest from other colleagues. For example, when I ask colleagues before distribute it, okay, how approximately it takes time, okay, this is 10, 11, 12, and at the end you say, okay, it's an average take 10 minutes, for example. So this is concerning to our discipline territory understanding, let us say, not in general understanding. Exactly. This is as well. Yeah. Some you feel something went wrong. In this case, something went wrong. That means okay, I have to drop out here because really, really, it's not understood anymore. Huh? Exactly. 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 Somehow. Yeah. But actually, this is. I haven't seen it, and I didn't see it. I just say honestly to people because I know that my questionnaire will take a long time. I said it takes 30 minutes. And maybe it takes five or 10 minutes more. Huh? I said it honestly in the beginning. And otherwise, or however, I at the end, I find a lot of dropout quotes. That means I don't know. I need to find out exactly which reason push people this. And I receive exactly, almostly the reason that the reason was mostly with design aspect. Yes, probably it's an idea as well to take it that not only your colleagues, not only your circle, small circle, but as well go outside a little bit. Yeah, exactly, it was different kind of. And this is what I said to you, that is very, very interesting to keep your community around. Because if you need anybody, just to reach it directly, without any effort. This is very, very important. So, in sum, I would say, okay, here was 13 page, and 3x, that means three of them were too long. Too long design, that means it's not only screen, but it takes three or four screen under each other. This is the story here. The story here as well, Mrs. Lawrence has as well some kind of three deeply or just long kind of design, exactly similar like here. And here was the optimal solution, actually. It was 17 page, very simple, very faster to read, understandable, and so on. For that reason, it was some kind of received a lot of completed users. This is the main issue of design, how to improve it. And I would say as well, sometimes here especially, if you are going to deal with this kind of, you find here, for example, probably user came here and be lost somehow. He overwhelming here, a lot of text here he has to take. This is as well should be, make it easier a little bit, make it with design somehow, with lines differently, or you could make as well some kind of half and half. When you fill in online questionnaire in Yahoo, for example, a Yahoo company, you find always under your fill in data description between brackets, e.g. blah 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 blah. And this is I have read one research, one piece of paper was investigating the difference between to put some kind of explanation under the field should be filled out or to not put. And they found very interesting that people, when the user find some kind of example here, make it very successfully and faster. When he found some kind of explanation down. When there is no, might be perceived a lot of confliction. So, might be interesting as well to care about it. When you make some kind of mask, should be filled, you write under here, e.g., some kind of, okay, you should put here, and you give him an example, for example. This make it the message much easier. Okay, marketing. This is might be interesting as well to know exactly what we have done to deliver, to announce about our surveys. And it's various kind of communication we have done. For example, in first survey, we make, it's readable for you, or should I focus? For example, in first one here, this is my experience here. I make two round email around TU Dresden. When I have done my questionnaire, I have done the pre-test, everything runs well. So I start to announce about my questionnaire. First way, I have taken this two round email from it from TU Dresden. And here I just collect some kind of, conflection. If I am dealing with PhD students in Dresden University of Technology, it's a bit tricky because not all PhD students are registered. Some of them external, and some of them doing research assistant, but they are not registered. So I have to deal with two kind of organization. Firstly is Students Affair, this is in German, Immigration Amt. And to deal with Office of Personal Affairs, this is Personal Amt. I have to deal with two main organizations in order to allow me to send my message for registered PhD students in Office of Personal Office of Students Admission Affairs, and as well with the Office of personal affair in order to receive employed PhD students at TU Dresden. Might be interesting as well to know that I sent with recognizing of data and the privacy data issue direct email to chairs and the professors, and it was very interesting. Some professor really guide me a lot and forward my message to other students, to his students, for example. I talk with my colleagues in forest faculty and they said to me, my supervisor forward for us your message and we deal with it. So you make some kind of trust that you give the head, the boss, your message, and the boss by himself distribute it somehow. This is give you some kind of, or give your message some kind of trust and being followed. What was really interesting as well, Facebook group. You know that TU Dresden is leading such kind of direction now. That they have a fan page at Facebook now. Everybody can read it. I contact with the admin and I said to her, okay, I would like to announce about my questionnaire. She said to me, in fan page, it's not allowed for anybody to vote it, but we have additional group. So they have additional group, and during this group, I announced about my questionnaire, and I receive as well feedback from others. So this is what I have followed to announce about my message. To please be noticed that is round email takes from 2 weeks to 3 weeks. If you are willing to go in such a procedure, it takes from 2 weeks to 3 weeks exactly. Do not be surprised. Survey number two as well, she sent round email to Chemnitz and Dresden to some kind of college head office and as well directly to college staff. And she makes something really interesting as well in terms of marketing. She makes flies and used chance in other in one of workshop to deliver her message as well here to announce about her. Why not? You can make as well flyers as well for your questionnaire. Wherever you go, you can announce people, you can give people to take with you just to collect by yourself as well. So it's two effort, personal effort from your side and as well official effort from sending around email and so on. This is second one. Third one was it was concerning to let us say survey number three concerning scientific scientist, and it was held by coordinator of our project. She sent to me exactly this kind of four: mailing of data center, mailing of human resource department, mailing dinner of research, mailing of faculties. So this is our way to deliver the message, to announce and to get people connected. Do you have any question around announcement, or do you have other idea? Do you have experience, especially those of you who are working in marketing and just, you know, if you have a lot of experience and ideas around marketing stuff? No? Okay. Once I make something strange, I was attending summer school and I make, maybe you'll laugh, but it was crazy idea, but might be interesting. I make t-shirt and I print advertisement of my research in t-shirt and I present my lecture on t-shirt printed with my questionnaire or my model of data. And all over I make like this, okay, and like this, and like this, and like this. Some kind of you get some fun for people, and as well, it's strange, and we will feel really relief and was really, really encouraged to follow this research. Why? Because some kind of freak idea I have done. So you have to be freak somehow. As well, if you are creative, just bring it on table and let people know exactly what you have it. You can make t-shirt, you can make even stuff for kitchen, and you make advertisement somehow. Just do, it's really creativity. You can do what you want to announce your people and to let people as well get connected with your research. It was one great idea as well for announcing to make advertisement. to make a movie, short movie as well. There are really, really intelligent movie for announcing on YouTube. You can see how people announce their stuff. Simply does not cost anything, and it's really reachable from a lot of people around you. So social media really bring us on life, bring us together, get us connected really strongly. And if you bought your video on YouTube, thousands, millions, you can see it, you can be announced from your stuff. You can use it. Why not? If it doesn't have any kind of influence of your data privacy. Okay, so let us see to time duration. Might be interesting as well to know exactly the difference between completed and dropouts, and which, how much time they used to fill in. Let us see to first one and focus here, for example. And you can see here, this is really interesting to know exactly how much time they used to fill in. This is completed. They already completed the survey. It started from 11 minutes. This is by minutes. Started from 11 minutes. I said it takes 30 minutes and might be as well 5-10 minutes more. Till half an hour and an hour. This is as well interesting to know that some people really feel patient. 1.5 hours to fill it out. This is this is very good questions, but I cannot confirm it, unfortunately, because I don't have any control tools to tell me. But wait, I have something. I can show you later here in my laptop. We have something like this. In Unibark, when you export your data from Unibark to SPSS, for example, you know SPSS. And this file includes pages are visited or are used. And you can find the name of the page. And next column here, duration for each page. Duration for each page, for every page. I mean duration for every page. So from this you can know exactly how much time has been sent for filling in this. And by the way, I found something really interesting. There are one page, two persons spend 1 hour in one page. I don't know how that has been done this. 1 hour in one page. Just pause in one page 1 hour and then continue. But this is very interesting to know. Very interesting to know the behaving of people when they fill out your questionnaire. Some people are stuck 1 hour with one question and then, I still have something here, so continue. Maybe he has a call, he was busy. And when he switched off his browser, he found out that something still should complete. So you can expect something. But it's very interesting to know how people behave online. This is very interesting to know. Not everyone's, okay, I'm sending here, 1, 2, 3, and I finish it. No. As I said to you, one people stuck 1 hour in one page. Okay, I have a rest now, and they will do something else. And at the end of the day, okay, I'm still here, so continue it. I'm not sure if you still have the level of motivation, or he lost his motivation, or he showed, okay, I need to finish this job and this is all. You don't know, you cannot decide. But this is interesting to know. The quality of your data as well depends on such activities, on such action as well. Yes, I remind myself. There is option in your work. Okay, this is the completion way and this is dropout way. Let us see how dropout looks like. Look, drop out here, start from 2 seconds or 2 minutes. No, 2 seconds. 2 seconds till 30 minutes.
What is exactly a dropout? Is it to cancel the questionnaire before answering the last question, or is it to complete the questionnaire?
The problem for me is dropout. That they didn't complete till the end. This is my problem. And especially when it comes in the middle, in my questionnaire. Why? This is actually kill me, It make me crazy. Why? Yeah? You should just feel patient for 5 minutes and I will have horrible amount of data. It can really be a massive data, very, very helpful for my research. But why actually? I need to know, and we need to know actually why dropout could be happened like this. Look, it is 30 minutes has been invested for filling your online questionnaire, and then he decided to fill out after half an hour. This is 5 minutes, and you could complete my survey. Why not? This is as well. It should be considered. Why such people make like this, and in which page they drop out? What's the mostly frequent page for dropouts as well? This comes later with us, but this is to know the behaving of dropout people. This is very interesting. Second survey. Here, you can see. This is a survey of my colleague Anya here. This completed, started with 4 minutes. That means he finished survey in 4 minutes. As well, you can think about the quality of data. What quality of data you should receive when you see that is one person finish in 4 minutes. As well, it's a question raised somehow. When, how many, look, two or just you can account here. Till 5 minutes, for example, or till 7 minutes, Or let us here, stuck in this area. 4 minutes, 5 minutes, it's enough time to give you quality result from such person, and how he looks like actually to give such kind of feedback. He's expert. Maybe he is you. You make it when you just didn't realize. What is this actually? We should ask ourselves actually the quality of data from such a person as well. Here I need to focus on dropouts from second as well. It's from 13 seconds to 200 minutes dropout. Look, imagine he stand here. Look. Yeah. Yes. Exactly. Look. What was happening actually? He dropped out, but he's still online. Still seeing or just active in my questionnaire for 3 hours. What is this? What is this? And here as well. Look. Here as well. Stay 30 minutes. What he's doing actually, what he was doing in 30 minutes, when he already decided to quit from my survey, this question should be raised as actually. And this is influence about the quality of data. Quality of your data depends on such activities, on such action, should be delivered. When at the end you receive the data and you say, oh, I get the very important result and I'm here and please show your data. But you didn't even realize that still quality insurance still should be discussed.
Would you add information what these guys were doing? For example, one guy who took off after 28 minutes. So what you can do is you just take his answers and see what question he was just dropping off. And at what time he was answering the questions before. So every time he makes a click, and you return back, so the screen was still open, but he had nothing to do and just close it.
But the point is, to what extent we can use this data? And you know, it's, it depends on structure of your survey and when exactly he quit out. If we say, okay, he just fulfills a part of demographic data, the first part, and he quit out, just run away before attitude scale. So we can use this data only for as demographic data. His filling out his most important information as only limited by demographic data. But we cannot use it in terms of attitude scale, in terms of his feeling, his motivation, his stuff.
It's why did he just quit the questionnaire? And the second point, I was just trying to find an answer for the second point. I think you have some hints in your data that could tell you, was it a fast guy or a slow guy? How did he progress through the questionnaire? And at what point did he actually drop out? And what questions were answered? And what speed? And so on. And I think that gives you a hint. If he just lost the motivation, or if he really had problems with the questionnaire, for example, he took it took him minutes to answer every question, for example. So then he took it at all in the sum, 2 hours for completion, and then he lost motivation. I don't know. All these data is somehow in the lock of the server, I think. And just, we have to look at this particular person. How did he behave? How did he answer the question about time and so on? I think this gives quite good information on the reason why he quits. And the other question, once again, is if you can still use these public data on this or if you haven't seen it.
For first part of your recommendation, it's matter for me to know exactly why he dropped out. But to measure it, this is the point. To measure it with Unibark, this is a point. I have literature review said, okay, we will develop some kind of tool to give you some kind of bar of data with clicks. For example, how many clicks per minute, for example, and how many clicks per page itself, and how many clicks between questions themselves. And this is could be very, very, very interesting to give you more detailed information about behaving itself. Exactly. But this is a point, this is the tools. It's not available on Unibark in terms of data privacy as well. We shouldn't use it until we will ask. If it's allowed for us to observe the clicks of user, how many clicks he has done, in which time he was so fast to click, 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 click to finish, or click and think and click and think. And this is kind of very interesting information to know. But unfortunately, we don't have tool to measure it in Unibark. I have read paper, he developed, as I said to you, tool, especially tool to measure such clicks. I contacted with the author, actually, and I said to him, I am really interested to work in this tool. Could you please give me allowance? But he didn't reply, actually. This is probably has a reason as well, still developing, or they still just make something with it. But as I said to you, we were trying somehow to use benefit data from Unibark in terms of BARA data, administrative data for your questionnaire to deliver for us some meaning, some new meaning. That means instead to throw away this data, no, please bring the data back on track, as I said to you, as our motto in the beginning, and let us see what it gives us for information. But as well, we are limited, as I said to you, with Unibark, unfortunately. Still, it's a matter of research in the future. I submitted in GUR, this is General Online Research, will be held in Mannheim next week. And there are a lot of speakers and papers around this issue, this bar data. Probably I will discuss with them exactly how to collaborate in the future to just adopt some data for our questionnaire. This is. But it's for sure, it's, your question is very interesting. But as I said, we need tools. Third one, this completed from 6 to 50 minutes. And this is the stereotype or timeline. It's still 1 hour almost for this coordinator survey to think it. This is as well. I can give you my experience around this this issue. I am one person who follow online questionnaire, not because only to help people, but because to see what kind of items they are researching with. So I am doing 2-in-1. I am filling in and complete the survey, and at the same time, I'm studying items. Huh? I'm seeing what they are doing, actually. What's behind this question, and what is this, and if this is interesting to take or not, huh? I'm the person like this, so it depends on motivation of the participant himself. Huh? If I'm going to fill in at the end and goodbye, this is my job, or you are going to make, no, this is self-satisfaction for myself. I need to know. Huh? I'm really interested at this point. Which item has been used? Huh? Which item really interesting to my research to take and to reuse and something like this. So as I said, it depends on the person. As I said, this is completed from 6 to 50 minutes, and this is, in my opinion, the better case in our survey here. And this is dropout from a coordinator survey as well. You can see here till 20 minutes as well, 15 minutes, 8 minutes, 6 minutes. He can finish this questionnaire, but you don't know what's happening for those people here. That was duration. Let us see much more interesting here. You can see actually the day of time to complete. And this, as I said to you, it depends on culture of participants. Here, for example, in my survey, was the most important year. It was 13, but this is in Greenwich zone, Greenwich time zone. That means add additional 2 hours for it. That means here would be 3 o'clock. So 3 o'clock p.m. was the most proper time for participants to take part in my survey. 3 p.m. for PhD students all over TU Dresden, 3 p.m. it's proper time. Why? This is a question I cannot ask, I cannot answer, but this is interested to raise such a question. Why 3 p.m. it's the most time? And then come 9 in the beginning as well. 9 a.m., the beginning of the day, and in the middle of the day after lunchtime. This is 2 cases to be considered for you as well in the future. Dropout. Dropout as well, you can see at 11. At 11 a.m. was the most dropout. Why 11 p.m.? It's preparing for lunch. I don't have time to fill in. It's some kind of... how it looks like in your daily time, 11 o'clock. What is 11 o'clock means for your daily time? It's a time of drinking coffee with colleagues, or it's time to finish what's really urgently to do in your day because you still have fresh mind. What means 11 o'clock a.m. for your daily task? This is very interesting to ask. And why here raised as the most frequently time has been used for students, for PhD students. As well, this is interesting to know during culture of people. Second was here as well at 4 o'clock. That means 2 additional hour we have to add here because it's Greenwich time. That means 4 o'clock was the most time for completion, the questionnaire. And that was the case of teacher. So we have some kind of different now. We have PhD student case, we have teacher case, and we have scientist case. And everybody of those community, let us say, of those disciplines or culture has his own prefer time. For teacher was 4 o'clock. I don't know, this is they finish lecture or they have break between lecture or... This question I'm raising now, not because I need answer, but I need you as well with me to think. To what extent we can use such data to bring for us something really useful. And here doesn't have really any meaning here. Doesn't have any meaning, actually. This drop out, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, for each time of the day. 6, 7, 8, 11. I cannot say anything here. Doesn't give any useful data. Let us see. Okay, this is survey number 3. We can see as well scientists. This is a case of scientists. And not only in Dresden University of Technology, but as well in all Saxon faculties and the colleges. It's 9 o'clock a.m., the preferred time for scientists to help people or to be satisfied with others' work. Maybe because this is as well, it's an urgent time, urgent task to do, to know what other they are doing and to what extent you can collaborate with them to open project with them to, you know, to get connected with them. This is as well very important to know from scientist point of view. I should finish in few seconds here. And this is dropout as well. It's the same, 9 o'clock, and might be interesting here at 2 o'clock after lunchtime, dropout. It works in opposite. Sometimes it works that, okay, I don't have nothing to do to help people. I can help people, but in other case, no, doesn't work. As well, it should bring some information. I will jump firstly to hear, very interesting to know exactly from my experience how people act. And when you send to them emails, look, the highest part here was round email. Response of people after sending round email. This is here and here. And between, this is individual effort from my side. I send individual to professors, and the professor send forward to students, and then, so look, it's very interesting in my opinion. Still people coming, 3 months. 3 months I'm trying, and still people coming and taking part in my survey. And this is really interesting to know. 2 times, as I said, around the email and between individual emails to colleagues directly or to professors. And professors send forward to their students. And this is the graph explain this action. By the way, in the times it was summer vacation. Between semester time, it was summer vacation. And a lot of people traveled somehow, not a lot staying in their services or in their offices, but as well might be interested for doctoral students to do some kind of research. They don't have teaching, they don't have students anymore, so might be they have time for doing some kind of research. And here as well, dropout as well might be interesting as well. The same here and here. This is around the email, dropout, and the dropout during between. Okay, missing here and here as well. The biggest columns here is around email, and here probably too. I don't know exactly. This is decision still with my colleagues. I need to ask her exactly what's happening here between 2 round email. But anyhow, I'm almost finished. Still some kind of data. but might be interesting to know exactly the feedback of people. This is some kind of feedback. It's sent to my survey, how people react and how people find it very not understood somehow. And that was one of the commented has been sent to me from one colleagues in biology discipline. So biology discipline, as I said to you, has other understanding for the point of view. They use the same tool, but differently way, in different understanding. It's really pretty hard to catch the point from my point of view directly, as I said to you. Might be as well interesting to know, here you are lucky because this is in German language. You can read, it's readable, it's okay. You can, this is for my colleagues, Anya, sent to her as well to know challenges has met people in understanding, and people stay, keep on away from technology somehow, and they don't like to take part in this. Some kind of tips that has been given here should be taken, and as well some kind of here other kind of some people already quit from job. They inform I'm not in service anymore. Yeah. As well, as I said, people still feeling some kind of scare from using new technology, and as well. And this is might be interesting to know this feedback. And from our coordinator, it was this raised previously. How it looks like. As well, as I said, it's a misunderstanding from what the meaning of tool and so on, from different kind of view. Okay, this is, I have as well information about gender. If any of you are interested, we can discuss later. And as well about disciplines, dropout and completed for our project, and the kind of motivation as well. As I said to you, this kind of motivation should be realized from people that the knowledge, self-efficacy, satisfaction, reciprocity, and enjoyment in helping others. And a lot of literature said this obviously, said this is this kind of motivation for people who participate for this kind of. Last one, this kind of dropout badges, how it looks like from statistics. This is demographic data, BART, and this is Likert scale BART. And look how people equate from my questionnaire. Some people decide in the beginning, and still some people here taking increase the number here in two pages here. A lot of dropouts still in the beginning of questionnaire. And Likert scale start from here as well, and a little bit from second. But the most important in this department, they decide to run away. Okay, this is our research, our project, web page information. If you would like to have a look, if you would like to take to read about our project as well, we have Porter already developed and published, but still closed for us, and we would like to open it later for all researchers and scientists in Germany, all here. But still, this decision not taken yet. So thank you for your attention. And if you have any questions, we can just make it faster.